when I saw you standing there under the stars. I knew it wouldn't be the last time. Scrolling through the memories of when we began, I couldn't find a single regret.
Your dreams collide with reality. You're lost in the fog, no answer in sight. You can't find a pill to make it all right. What would I give to make it all right? If you ever start doubting, when it's hard to keep hoping, I just want you to know that I believe in you. When you're tired of fighting and it feels like you're broken, I just want you to know that I believe in you. If you ever start doubting, when it's hard to keep hoping, I just want you to know that I believe in you. When you're tired of fighting and you feel like you're broken, I just want you to know that I believe in you. Look how far you've come.
It's like falling rain on the driest plains, as far as eyes can see. This love is like the church bells, as loud as they can ring. In the good man's face on his wedding day, when he sees his bride-to-be. It's like a little girl holding daddy's hand, for everyone to see. Yeah, this love is like no other, it's taking over me. Nobody loves you like I do, and I never want them to. Nobody loves you like I do, and I can't get.
Ceremony of the marriage of Clyde and Kris, and on behalf of Vaughn, Maureen, Christopher and Karina, we welcome you to this beautiful celebration in the open air. Now today you will learn the great Australian wave, which is this. If you avoided being an Australian until now, you no longer can. I am also Ilocano, as you can tell by my eyes. Born in Baguio, not really. This is a Christian wedding and we will pray, so if you don't mind just bowing your heads to start this ceremony with prayer. Precious Lord, we are so grateful that today we can be here together to celebrate this amazing wedding, this amazing marriage, Lord. Between these two beautiful people. Father, I pray that you bless these beautiful people. I thank you for their families. I thank you for their friends who have come out here, who made this possible. I pray, Lord, that this ceremony honors you in every way so we can enjoy who you are in us. So we hand it over to you and glorify your mighty name. Amen. We will hear an item from Rivan right now, a worship song.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days have been held in hands. From the moment that I wake up, sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. Yes, all my life I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I have made, I will sing of the goodness of God. Yes, I'm gonna sing of the goodness.
Give her a big hand. That is a beautiful worship song. Well done, well done, Riva. I'd like to read a passage from Genesis chapter 2, verses 18 to 24. Today we will speak about God and about His creation. And the best way to learn about marriage is to learn of God. So in Genesis, the Lord said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make him a helper suitable for him." Now the Lord God had formed out of the ground all the wild animals and the birds in the sky. He brought them to the man to see what he would name them, and whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name. So the man gave names to all the livestock, the birds in the sky, and all the wild animals, but for Adam no suitable helper was found. So the Lord God caused man to fall into a deep sleep, and while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and then closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. The man said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh." So today we want to learn a few lessons from creation. God said initially, "It is not good for man to be alone." Most of the troubles and problems and issues that are coming in our lives, they come when we choose to be alone. And God said, it's not good to be alone. There will be temptation in life where you'd want to be alone. And you want things done your way. God said, it's not good to be alone. In fact, it won't be just I, me, myself. It will be my wife and I. Let me check. It's us. It's ours. The language changes. It's not good to be in life. It's not good to be alone also in your journey, in your spiritual journey. You know, when Adam opened his eyes for the first time, when God breathed life into him, he saw God. He had fellowship with God. Man was not created to live alone without God. Most of the trouble in our life is because we choose not to acknowledge God and to live away from Him. But Adam walked with God in the cool of the morning. He walked with God every day. And in Christ Jesus, we can do exactly that. Every day we can walk with God in the cool of the morning. It's not good to be alone. Just as the fish cannot survive outside the water, we cannot survive without God. He breathed life into us, and every day people are gasping for the breath of God. What is everybody chasing out there? They are chasing the very breath of God. What is very interesting, when God makes the woman, He causes man to fall asleep. So ladies and gentlemen, if your husbands fall asleep on the couch, just know that God causes them to fall asleep. It's a common trend for men. They will fall asleep a lot quicker than women. But that's okay, because God does some work on them while they're asleep. So let them sleep. He does some work that will benefit you. He performs a surgery and gets the rib out, and He makes a woman out of it. And when Eve opens her eyes for the first time, who does she see? It's not Adam. Adam is still in the recovery ward. She sees God. She doesn't even know that Adam exists. She has fellowship with God. She spends time with God. It's not good for the woman to be alone either. It's not good for man to be alone. Each one of them must have a fellowship, a relationship with God. And when they both have a relationship with God, then she's brought to the man. And that relationship, that fellowship is established in the marriage. God is into marriage. You know, the Bible begins with the marriage of Adam and Eve. Jesus' ministry begins at a wedding in Cana. Do you know how the Bible will end? With the church being the bride of God, of Christ. God is into marriages. God is into weddings. And God wants every marriage to be successful. There is no separation. There's nothing allowed, because God wants us to be in fellowship with one another. So in life, whenever you want to go alone, know that God didn't want you to go alone. In fact, He says that your body doesn't belong to you anymore, Clyde. It belongs to her. She's the boss of your body, man. And He's the boss of your body. And there shouldn't be any other person in between you. Nothing should come between you anytime. That bond that God has made has to remain for life. What was man's first job? Man's first job was to give identity to the animals and then to his wife. Can you imagine the responsibility a man has in this life? He's an identity giver. Clyde, you got to give Kris an identity. You got to give your children an identity. You'll name your children and you will give them the identity as sons and daughters of the living God. Fatherhood is a massive responsibility. It is a priesthood. And motherhood is a massive responsibility. You know, it's very interesting that Adam called her a woman. You know, the word woman has the word man in it. But what does the womb mean from the beginning, at the beginning of the word woman? It's a word womb. A woman is a man with a womb. So when God created humanity, He already created a woman, and the seed of the woman will crush the serpent's head. In her, in Eve, God already planted the coming of Jesus Christ in their womb. And thousands of years later, Jesus came and He destroyed the works of the devil. This is how powerful this is. So God creates a male and female, nothing in between. No matter how much humanity tries to play with this, they can't make a womb. They can do plastic surgery, but they can't make a man into a woman or a woman into a man. Because God created a woman with a womb. And from that womb, Jesus Christ was going to be born. And Jesus would destroy the works of the devil. What an amazing responsibility for the woman to carry the children that God gives as a gift to this world. Let me tell you something. There's no greater gift that humans have here in this life than procreation. So I want to encourage you, all of you here, have children. Have children. Because that is the greatest joy that you will have in this life. Money will go, everything else will go. The children will outlive you. And in them, you can instill the powerful message of the gospel. And with them, you will spend eternity. Your houses, your money, your influence will all be left behind in this world. But your children, you can take you to eternity, to honor God. Invest into kingdom and give identity. You know what's interesting? Jesus went to Simon and he says, Simon, I'm going to change your name. I'm going to give you a new identity. I will call you Peter. And on your testimony that I am the Christ, the Messiah, I will build my church. On the very words that you stated that I am Christ, the Messiah, I will build my church. Jesus is into giving new identities to people. And he passed on that mantle also to the priest in the household, the father. Men who are here, husbands, and young men who will be husbands in the future, I want you to assume this responsibility and take on the mantle of priesthood and be the identity giver to your wife and to your children. And then God said, a man leaves his father and mother and is united or joined, cleaved to his wife, and they become one flesh. The man and the woman become one flesh, one accord. Never an idea of being separated. God set the rules for marriage. If you obey the rules that are in the Bible, you will prosper in life. All the problems that you have today in life are because you don't obey the rules, the priorities, the laws of God. When He created us, He put into motion some boundaries, some laws. He is faithful. He doesn't even have to judge you because the law has judgment in itself. It's just like gravity. If you jump off a building, gravity will kill you. God doesn't have to kill you. If you don't honor the bed in marriage, judgment is coming upon you. It will destroy the marriage. It will destroy everything you've treasured so much. There's no negotiation. This is life and death. And marriage is so, so powerful and is a godly entity. Never underestimate the responsibility we have as husbands and wives and this oneness, this joining that God has made. No man is to separate what God has united. Have this mindset, have this commitment, this covenantal commitment to marriage. And live within the boundaries that God has given you, because these boundaries are healthy, they're good, they're wonderful, they're enjoyable, and they bear fruit. And I want to leave you with this passage. And this passage is very important to me because my father, when he passed away at the age of 52 on his knees, praying, he had the Bible at this Bible open at this passage. And this is the passage that has brought salvation to me. And it still works in me amazing, amazing things. So I want you to take this to heart and read it and meditate on it and grow with it. And it is found in Joshua 1:8. And most of you would have heard this passage before. But today, I want you to run with it. And especially you, Clyde and Kris. Take this passage as a blessing for you. This is what God said to Joshua. So Joshua is about to lead the people in the promised land. And God speaks to Joshua. And look at the formula he gives him for a successful taking over of Canaan. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth. So, for the laws of God to be on your mouth, you must be reading them, you must be memorizing them, and you must be uttering them, you must be saying them. So you must know so well the laws of God and the principles of God and values of God and priorities of God that you don't just know them, but you actually utter them, you say them, you verbalize them. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night. To meditate on it is to regurgitate, is to spend time on it over and over and over, to go over it, to allow them to infuse you, to go deep in you, to be embodied in you, the word of God to become flesh in you, so that you may be careful to do according to all that is written in it. So the purpose for you to meditate on the word of God is to do it. A lot of people like to hear the word of God. They like to go to church and hear a good message. But so few people actually go and do it. So the purpose of you meditating on the word of God is to actually do it, to apply it in your life. And look at the benefits when you do that. For then, you will make your way prosperous. You will make wise decisions. You will prosper in life. We all want this couple to prosper in life. We all want everyone to prosper in life. And then you will have good success. So good success is a byproduct of you obeying the laws of God. Good success and prosperity come when you take the laws of God and you apply them in your life. When you take the priorities, when you take the values, when you take the perspectives of God and apply them in your life. You can't aim for success in life. Success is a byproduct of obedience to God. So in this marriage, I want you to take the book of God's law. Meditate on it day and night. Read it together. Kris, before you go to bed, say to Klyde, read me a passage and let's pray together. Let me tell you a secret. The rest you can shut your ears if you don't want to hear it. This is just between the three of us. The most difficult prayer you will ever pray is with your husband and with your wife. This is the most difficult prayer you will pray in life. It's easy to pray by yourself. It's easy to pray with people in church, with family. But the most challenging prayer is between the two of you together when you kneel before God. You can ask other people. You can ask other Christian couples. Ask them, how often do you pray together? How often do you kneel together and you pray together? Do you know why this is the most difficult prayer? This is the most difficult prayer because this is the most powerful prayer. This is the most powerful prayer. Do it every day. Ground yourself for 3 minutes and kneel before the Lord. Just pray together. Hold hands. Cry together. Smile together. Laugh together. And be one with God. Walk privately with God by yourself. And also walk together with God. And then good success and prosperity will follow. They'll be natural products of your supernatural life in Christ. God wants to give you His wisdom. He wants to give you the mind of Christ. Don't sell yourself short. Don't sell yourself short. So just grab everything and take this Joshua 1:8 and run with it. Amen? Do you agree with me? Great. Thank you for having the patience to listen to this message. We will transition now into the vows. Are you ready to make the commitment? Allow this moment to sink deep. We don't rush. Do you, Klyde, Nairo Bakala, take Kris Adon to be your wife in a covenant of marriage before God? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only onto her for as long as you both shall live? Do you, Kris Adon, take Klyde Nairo Bakala to be your husband in a covenant of marriage before God. Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only on to him for as long as you both shall live? Now you also have some personal vows that you like to recite.
Thanks, Pastor. I need a cheat sheet. You look great. My dearest Kris, finally we made it. You don't know how happy I am marrying the woman I love. Sorry. The woman who loves me for who I am. Kris, you have opened my eyes to see and appreciate different things, different perspectives in life. And you taught me one of the most important aspects in a relationship, which is to communicate and relate. You should know that you are a gem and that it is delightful to see you cultivate relationships around you with ease, and I love that. I love you for just being yourself, you know, bubbly, energetic, and caring, which to me is very attractive. Your relationship with your parents and siblings is the most genuine and loving I have seen in a family, and I admire it a lot. And because of that, I would like to take this moment to thank your family, especially Uncle Kris and Uncle Auntie Karina, for raising such an amazing and beautiful woman, inside and out. Although you raised her quite loud, but I've gotten used to it. I'll just have to make sure that I'll add hearing aids on my health insurance. I'm just kidding. Babe, thank you for loving me and all of my imperfections. You stuck with me even when I had nothing but my love for you, and reminded me to celebrate even the tiniest successes in our lives. You showed me how to love, even when for a moment I didn't believe in love. I don't really deserve you, but I thank God every day for being so generous, for allowing a loving woman like you into my life. A lot of people say that you are lucky to have me, but in all honesty, I really am the lucky one. And Kris, I love you with all my heart, and I promise to protect and take care of you for the rest of my life. I promise to listen to your goals every day, every week, every month, basically all the time. I promise to hike all the mountains in your list with you, when we can, of course. And I promise to be better for the both of us every day. I am excited for what God has in store for us. And I cannot wait to start our own little noisy family. You know, little Kris, little Klyde, running around, being loud, like their mom. And I can live with that. I love you, my soon-to-be wife, always.
Thank you, babe. Thank you, sis. Thank you, love, for that really good bow. So, this is mine. Love, I just want to start my bow by thanking our Almighty God for granting my prayer. I remember the first time I laid my eyes on you. That was 12 years ago in Caddington. I prayed to God that my future husband should be one who's personally opposite of mine. Everyone knows we're completely different in a lot of ways. And here you are, my answered prayer. And I'm very grateful to God. It feels like a dream marrying my longtime crush, who, by the way, rejected me multiple times. Fine, I'll admit. I previously asked you if you can be my boyfriend, but I guess you are not ready for me yet. But here we are now, ready to seal our hearts. Today marks our 7 years of being together. And since it's our 7th year anniversary, I have prepared my vows to start our marriage. Firstly, I vow to firstly love and seek God. I promise to always put God in the middle of our marriage because we both know that our faith is the most important things above all. Second, I vow to always honor you and to love you despite of our unique personality and differences. To laugh and cry with you through our highs and lows. I vow to always be your number one fan, to always support your wins and losses, to always encourage you to be the best version of yourself, because through them, your soul shines. I vow to always show kindness and speak good words towards you, most especially if I'm having what you said, Kris, moments. You know that what I mean, right, love? Fifth would be, I vow to always be your partner in all things, not possessing you, but working with you. For there is nothing we cannot face if we stand together. I vow to never give up on our marriage. I have faith in God that marriage is the worth fighting for. And the best part of marriage is to grow old with you. Lastly, I want to finalize this by saying, Klyde, thank you for fulfilling my dreams. Believe me when I say you are one of a kind. I'm so blessed to marry to the most loving, patient, kind, occasionally funny, pero I think ako yun. Charming, gentleman, and above all, I admire your faith and relationship with God. And with this personality that you have, I want to say also thank you to Auntie Mao and to Uncle Bon for raising such a good man. I can't say it's a boy because he's a really good man. And lastly, Klyde, thank you for being my best friend, my wife, companion. I mean, my wife, I'm sorry. My companion, my lover, and now my husband. Klyde, you are the great love of my life. I never knew what love is apart from ours, and I never want to know what love without you. Happy anniversary, love! You are now mine forever.
Not yet. Can you imagine their kids, how wonderful they will be? If I'm around, I'll probably marry them, right?
I give you this ring. As a visible constant symbol of my pledge to love you for as long as we both shall live.
I give you this ring as a visible constant symbol of my pledge to love you for as long as we both shall live.
Precious Lord, we thank you, Lord, for Klyde and Kris. And we thank you for what you've done in their lives. I can tell, Lord, that they have walked with you in the cool of the morning. And I pray, Lord, that from now on they'll walk together with you. I pray that they'll pray together. I pray, Lord, that they will be in your word together. I pray that they will bless others together. I pray that you bless them with children, with an extended family, with good friends. Protect them, guide them, cover them with your blood, and be with them every day of their lives. Pray that no sickness will come into this home. The enemy will have no stronghold, but they will prosper and they will love you for the rest of their life. I pray, Lord, that this family will remain strong and your blessing will be upon them every day of their lives. Amen. As a representative of Jesus Christ in the local church, and with the power invested in me as a minister of gospel in Australia by the Southern Cross Association of Churches, it gives me great joy in the presence of God to pronounce you Klyde Nairo Bakala and Kris Bakala, husband and wife. you may kiss your bride.
Everyone is ready. The entourage and the couple is ready. I can see them right there. Okay, let's all put our hands together and welcome the entourage.
So we'll start with the godparents, Mr. Rafael and Mrs. Dominica Quinto.
We have Mr. Depot and Mrs. Celeste Valdez.
And we'll have Mr. Anderson and Mrs. Jane Olsen. We have Mr. Nick and Mrs. Beverly Cablog. And we'll have Mr. Justado and Mrs. Rose Acabo.
Next up, we have our ring bearers, Kaden and Kendrick Bakala.
They are Clyde's nephew.
Next, we have the flower girls, Winona Santiago, Alexandra Mataxil, and Kaya Bumecha. Next up, we have the bridesmaid and groomsmen. May you please welcome Ariel. Next up, Wilford and Joad.
And we'll have Vaughn and Christine. And we have Tim and Janine. And now we have Reva.
We now move on to the maid of honor, Casey Adon Sibug. Unfortunately, she won't be able to be with us tonight due to border restrictions, but may I call on the best man for tonight, Mr. Kyle Bakala.
And now may we have the groom's parents, Mr. Vaughn Bakala and Ms. Maureen Kayat. And now we'll have the parents of the bride, Mr. Christopher and Mrs. Karina Adon.
Once again, let's give a round of applause to our entourage. You all look very beautiful and handsome tonight. And now, let us welcome the stars for tonight. Let us make some noise as we welcome our newlywedded couple, Mr. Klyde and Mrs. Kris Bakala!
Your toast is ready! Wow! All right, now we have our entourage in front.
They all look very stunning tonight, aren't they, Regine?
Yes, they do. And for our ninang and ninangs, I was wondering a while back, what was the criteria that you are the ninangs and ninangs now? But I do believe, mga ninangs and ninangs, always with the treasure and the gift of wisdom to our couple, as well as for the parents tonight.
All right, it was a very
special
ceremony earlier, isn't it, Regine?
It was.
What was your favorite part of the ceremony?
Kris, I'm sorry. It is when Kris said Klyde to be my wife. I just knew it's women empowerment. I love it. But before that, knowing the couple, it has always been a partnership for them. Klyde will always say, babe, hindi ah. And Kris will always say, babe, hindi ba?
I think the note is higher, Regine. You have to reach that note.
Yes. All right. Now that's for our entourage. And now we are moving to the next part of the program, which reminds me to our guest, please have your glass ready for our toast.
We will be hearing from Tito Christopher Adon, who is the father of the bride.
Hello. A little bit message to the husband and wife. Very congratulations to you. Your journey is already start now. And our message, just all in everything, we got all in God. So if you use the God in your all of circumstances in your life, will be become good. That's the only one I miss to you. Thus.
Raise your glasses, everyone, and one more. Cheers!
Remember the days of staying up late when we snuck in through your window. And your mom got so mad that I couldn't help but laugh when I saw how far back your eyes rolled. And we still don't do what we're told. We'll never get old. Yeah, we rode through town with our music too loud, and we sang out of tune every note. And we stood on the edge with your arms outstretched. I was Jack and you were my rose. And I swore I'd...
All right, moving on to the next part of the program, we will be hearing some lovely messages from the couple's parents. May I please call to the front the mother of the groom, Miss Kayat, Miss Maureen Kayat.
Hello. First of all, I'd like to say good evening to everyone, and I would also like to thank the elders of the land for accepting us to be here. I didn't really prepare any speech for tonight. Because it's just like we know Kris for a long time, and we already have accepted her to be a part of the family. So it seems like it's an everyday. But tonight it's official. She's already Mrs. Bacala, Mrs. Klyde, Klyde Bacala. Yeah. So, I have very mixed feelings. Actually, I'm happy. At the same time, I'm also sad because, like, my boys are already disappearing from me. Like, my first child got married, so I lost one child, although they're there. And now my another second child also is already officially married tonight. But, you know, I wish you really all the best. And I can only share my experiences being a wife and having a family for how many years? 23 years, and until now we're here. I'm still here as a mother. So for the both of you, you've been through a lot, I know, ups and downs. And I know that your love to each other had been tested for a long time. So for you, Klyde, all I can see is to love and to cherish your wife forever. Make the most of it to make you happy. And I hope that you're going to treat her as your equal, as your partner, not your second hand or something like that. So you will be growing all together as partners in life, okay? And then as your love grow also throughout the years. And you look after her. And also you, Kris, you'll be a mother one day. You'll also be loving your husband, and you'll be a loving mother to your children. So one day you'll have a children, and the focus will be on the children. So there will come a times that you'll be tested as well with all the pressures that will all be coming through your way. But I want you to be strong, as they say a while ago. You'll be the ilaw of the tahanan. So there will be times that you'll be happy. There will be times also that you will be sad. And as a mother, I'm telling you right now that you have to be very strong, okay? Because getting married is not really all just paradise or happiness as what you are thinking, but we are hoping for that, okay? So I welcome you officially to the family in behalf of my husband Vaughn and the children, other siblings, and all the relatives. I welcome you truly in our hearts, in our family. Yeah, and that's all.
Thank you very much, Tita Maureen Kaya.
Officially, you can call me Mama. Thank you.
Thank you, Tita.
Mom!
You'll take a
look. Yeah, all right.
Thank you so much again, Tita Maureen Kaya, who's the mother of Klyde. May we now call on Tito Vaughn Bacala, who is the father of the groom.
First of all, may give a big thanks to each and every one of us for coming and join us in this big day of Kris and Klyde to witness their vows to God. So thank you very much for coming, and let's enjoy for the day, join them for their big day. Okay, they told me we are going to be given just something like 5 minutes talk, but I think I'm going to make it 30 minutes, so just bear with me, okay? Because I'm going to talk about history. Okay, sorry for that. Like this. 2 years ago, okay, history na talaga, 2 years ago. We were eating in the dining table. And Klyde, I observed him that he's uneasy. Eating something like, what's happening to this boy? And said, then lately he said, Kris is going to propose to me, and we are going to marry him the November of 2021. And I said, Yeah. So I looked at Klyde and said, are you okay? And I said, is it Kris who is going to propose and marry you, or what? No. I am going to propose to Kris, and we will get married on the November 29, 2021. Okay, that's better to hear. Okay, just joking. Okay, that's it. That's why it's history. And I realized that later that he's just quite very happy to propose to me his proposal. There's something like he's to give me his proposal about their plan with Kris. And thank you very much for that. I like it. Okay? So, what I can say, Klyde is, we're losing Klyde already. As the bachelor in the family, now you're already getting married, and you're going to the next episode of your life. And that's it. We have to go there. So what I say is, yes, of course, before the calendar ends, you have to get married, because after the calendar, dates of the calendar will end, no more. I don't know what happened. Okay? That's more than a bachelor. And even to Kris, you're already at your age, so it's okay. So the approval is there. Okay? So, to Klyde, we are just so happy. We're very happy. I'm very happy to have you as my son, a very ideal man. He's quite serious. You're quite serious in everything you do. You're quite straight going. When you talk, you're straight, upright, and okay. No one will bother to say no. It's always it's always upright. And like just when you come home, everybody's just Klyde is there, and and later on just said, Riva, when are you going to finish your studies? Tonight. What? Tonight? No. Manong, 2 years from now, I will be finishing my studies. Okay. That's it. Then go to mom. Mom, when are you going to work at the hospital? Yeah. Or maybe tomorrow? Like, don't stress yourself. Don't stress yourself too much. That's Klyde. That's what I want from Klyde. He's straight going. You will ask what you want to say. And that's it. He will just give you immediately what he wants to ask, and you have to ask, you have to answer upright. That's it. Yeah. Dad, so we'll say, Dad, that's not a joke. You have to go to see your doctor now. Well, okay, I have to go. Go. I have to go to see my doctor. That's it. That's Klyde. Yes, a bit serious. Everything is something like you have to do what he said. And thank you for that, for something like you're an idea man, very, very, I don't know how I describe it. Yeah, more, I don't know how to say more words about to describe it. I can give some adjectives or what, yeah? And that's it, so, we are very happy to have you as a son, being proud of you. And sometimes you don't talk too much, and here comes Kris. You know Kris, your friend, friends of Kris, you know Kris, and which is the opposite. That's why, okay, it's being upset. Yeah, when Klyde's not talking too much and Kris is there, somewhat very charismatic, flamboyant. Okay, that's it. You know her, okay? And I said, okay, that's it. So that Klyde will be upset. The characteristics of Klyde will be upset and go together. Okay, so that's it. And I can't say anything. Maybe I will just say, by tomorrow will be a new day for you, a different day for you. You're already a couple. You're already a husband and wife. So what you do is, you just imagine that in front of you, you stand together in front of you. Maybe you can go to the beach. In front of you is there, and looking through the horizon of the sea, of the ocean. And you just imagine that there's a demarcation line. Demarcation line, what do you call it? Demarcation lines, a boundary line in front of you. Okay? Before you step there, You imagine that you have an old jacket. Remove your old jacket, put down in front of you, step on it. That's the old you. That is the old you. Once you go on the other side of that boundary line, that's already the marriage life. No turning back. That's it. You just imagine that you are doing that. That's already the next episode of your life. And on that side, there are so many roads to life. Your crystal ball is just there, very, very near crystal ball that you are going to get, but it's not just easy to get. On the roads that going there, you have to choose the right road. You have to choose the right avenue leading to that crystal ball. That is your aim, your goal, and everything that is your life. And the roads going there will define you, who you are. So this is the time that I will say, I'm going to give you your blessings, that God will bless you and give you the right wisdom and intelligence to choose the right road leading to your journey. Yeah, in case you at the time you have to pray to God also that say, God, please help me, please help us to choose the right path, the right avenue to our goal, to reach our goal. Okay, so if in case you choose the bad road, everything, every road leading to your goal, there are so many obstacles, hindrances, everything that will, there are sufferings, everything that you will meet on that road. And you cannot, that is life, you cannot deny that they will come anytime, that anytime they will come, okay? If you know that you cannot tackle your problem, we are always here. Come back to us. And as long as we can help, we can still give you our help, our advices, leading to your goal. That's it. And if in case you need financial, yes, do not come to me. maybe you go to your ninongs and ninangs. That's why they are very, very willing to sign your marriage contract, because they are very eager to help you financially. Maybe that's it. Just joking, okay? Yeah, if we are still available, we are still able and capable to help you. Okay, we can still while we are still alive. That's it. Okay. So that's it. And while on your way, don't forget to pray, to always ask the help of the Lord. Always say, God, help me, please. Always, God, help me, please. Always do that. Always ask the help of God leading to your goal, so that you will be spiritually blessed on your way. That's it. Okay. What more I can say? Of course, always bringing with you the word of God. Always love one another. Okay. Love one another always. I want to hear to everybody, can you please shout, love one another, please?
Love one another.
Thank you. Very, very clear. Love one another. It's not love another one. That's very different one. It's not love another one. Okay? It's very different. Right? You say, love one another. Then the other one, that's why. Because others, they misheard the word, that word. When you shouted it, it's love one another. Others, they did not hear it. That's why they said, what I heard is love another one. That's a keep loving another one when they're married already. That's bad. That's sad. Don't do that. Okay, so, and let's go any further. Congratulations for your big day. Keep it up. Keep the love growing. Keep the love burning while you are on your next episode of your life. Congratulations.
Wow. Thank you so much, Father of the groom, and now Father of the bride as well. Di po ba? And it's okay, Uncle, we can leave it there as well. And again, love one another. So that message is very clear. Thank you so much for that, Uncle Vaughn. And now we're moving on to Mr. Christopher Addon.
Hello, hello. Good evening, everyone. I just only tell this. Thank you for all of us coming here to witness the wedding of my daughter, my juniora. That's why I very thank you to all of you. And I'm very appreciative for that. But now, hanak nga maka-English, iso nga paspasensyahin nyo kung minsan Tagalog, Ilocano, Igorot. So, ang aking masasabi sa inyong mag-asawa, at dumating na ang punto na kayo ay nag-asawa na,
hindi na buhay binata at hindi buhay dalaga. Buhay mag-asawa ang inyong atopatigin na yun, hindi yung gaya ng dati. But normally, ganun lang ang buhay. Mayroon ang isang panig going sa binata, isang panig going sa asawa, but most of time, remember you have your obligation each other. That's the important one, obligation. Because if there's no obligation, nothing happen. Kaya ang masabi ko sa inyo, trust each other. Magtiwala sa isa't isa, kasi kung mawala yung tiwala, lahat, pati plato lilipad. Buti na lang at hindi ko nagaya ang tatay ko. Kasi ang tatay ko naman ay hindi naman nagpapalipad ng plato dahil sila ang mag-asawa, kundi nagpapalipad ng plato ang tatay ko noon dahil sakat tamaran mining maghugas ng pinggan. Kaya kayo, baka dumating ang punto yung mga anak ninyo ayaw maghugas ng pinggan, huwag lilipad ang plato dahil masama yun. Masama yun. Dahil kung sa amoy nilalagay ang pagkain mo at pinapalipad mo, aalis daw ang grasya. Kaya ito ang masabi ko. Just trust the God will in your journey in your life as a wife and husband. I think the God will guide you wherever you go. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, Tito Christopher Adon. May we now call on the mother of the bride, Mrs. Karina Adon.
Mag-iigwisa, gusto ko Tagalog kasi para ma-feel ko. Magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Salamat sa pagdalo ng kasalang anak ko. Ito lang masasabi ko, anak. Lahat sinabi na nila. Basta sa akin, sa mag-asawa, na andyan ang respeto, pagmamahalan at pag-uunawaan. Hindi rin darating sa mag-asawa may kaunting tampuan, pero huwag kayong matulog na may sama ng loob para huwag na niyo pa umagay ng misunderstanding ninyo. Para sa inyo, nasa gitna ninyo si Lord. And then, congrats mga anak. And client, welcome to our family. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Sheeta, for that very heartwarming and touching message. Next up, we would like to call on the brother of the groom to deliver his message, Mr. Kyle Bacala.
All right. Okay. All right. I prepared a speech, but I'm going to read it from my phone. All right. Good evening, everyone. To the guests who made it here, thank you for sharing your time to celebrate this romantic moment of Klyde and Kris. And by the way, for those who doesn't know me, my name is Kyle. I am one of the younger siblings of Klyde. I'm just kidding. I am the eldest one of all of them. Yeah. Okay, so firstly, it is a great honor and privilege to be the best brother. I mean best man to the best brother. Yeah. Okay, Klyde. Thank you for being such a stable hand to us. You know? You have been so helpful in so many ways, not only to me, but to the whole family. We had our ups and downs, and you have always spoken your truth. You have been a straightforward guy, you know, which meant you saw our mistakes before, and they would happen, and guided us to a solution always. I want you to know that we're really thankful we had you by our side, and I want you to know that we'll always be here, no matter what. No matter what your struggles will be. You know, always be. We'll be here. All right, to the beautiful bride, Grace. Thank you for being a wonderful partner to Klyde. Thank you for all the efforts you've done to make Klyde, I guess, the most happiest guy here tonight. I hope that you'll always continue to love Klyde and will always be the most energetic and wonderful woman for him. All right. So Klyde and Kris, tonight we celebrate you. We all wish you a lifetime of happiness, love, health, good health, success, and laughter, of course. Yeah. May you continue to find humor in the bad and appreciation for the good. May your friendship continue to grow throughout all the years to come. All right, cheers.
Thank you very much, Kyle Bacala.
So we will have a very special surprise to Kris and to everyone as well. We have your sister on the line, and she would like to give her speech as well.
She is also beautifully dressed up for tonight's occasion.
Sorry, guys, for the wait. Hello, Kris, and hello, Klyde. Good evening, everyone. Firstly, I would like to introduce myself. I am one of Kris's sister who is currently living at the nation's capital, Canberra, due to COVID circumstances. I'm not able to attend my dear sister's and Klyde's wedding.
She's crying.
Which is really upsetting. On the other hand, I'm so delighted on today's event. Hashtag Klyde sealed with a Kris. I would like to say thank you to everyone, to the parents, my family, Klyde's family, and the entourage and the catering, who is here and virtually to celebrate this special occasion. To the event organizers and helpers, thank you for making this day really amazing and special. To my brother Winston,
thank
you so much for doing all the hard work.
Hindi, may bayad.
My absence to make this beautiful.
Uy, sayang makeup.
Making this beautiful wedding dress that our sister is wearing. Thank you so much. To my parents, I am thankful for the, sorry. I'm thankful to our parents, Mama and Papa, that helps us for all the advices and wisdom that they have taught us. They taught us to have other, no matter what happens, and to love one another, as no one will be there for us except the family. They taught us how to respect others, and Papa especially keep reminding us to be humble and always put our heads down. Klyde's family, Vaughn, Auntie Mom, and Klyde's siblings, Riva and Vaughn, thank you for accepting my sister to be part of your family. You showed her kindness and made my sister feel welcome in your family. My sister isn't perfect. She has her flaws, yet you accepted her to be part of your growing family. Part of our family. Even though you rejected my sister multiple times, of which we are all aware, we are so happy that you finally said yes to her. Since the day my sister said she had a crush on you, I told to myself that you are the perfect guy for my sister. As we all know, my sister, she needs someone, but she needs someone that she would listen to, firm and straight.
Medyo ngalay na ako, girl, pero let's go.
She needs someone who would tell her to stay at home, to tell her she needs to say no at times, and able to slow down on her very spontaneous adventure. I am grateful that you said yes on taking good care of my sister and taking my responsibility as the strict and the nagging sister. Thank you. As I won't be able to do that as I am far away from where she is. I am also thankful for your accepting all her flaws. She has a lot of imperfection. What an ideal woman that most men would dream of. But I can assure you that Kris will never make your day boring. Once again, welcome to our loud family and hope you're slowly getting used to it. To be honest, I don't know how will I start my message to my sister. We've been together inseparable until I decided to move to Canberra. I remember when we were young, we always wear the same clothes, which I hated so much. Sometimes people think we were kids. My friends are your friends, and they look after you like their own sister. They love you more than they love me. She's the type of sister who will find her way to spend time and spoil his nephews and nieces. The constant caller who will call you just to say hello and see how things are going. The sister who will say sorry and bite you brunch just to make it up to you. The sister who always finds sunshine in times of darkness. I am blessed to have you as my sister and the auntie of my children. I can't believe how time has passed by and now you are married to the man of your dream. You've proven that patience is a virtue. It's just really sad that I won't be there to personally give you my message and celebrate this amazing moment of your life. I have been your nagger and your enemy for quite some time, actually until now. You are the sweetest sister I will ever have, yet you're the most stubborn and you make reckless decisions. When we were young, I would never think that she would go out with boys since she is so boyish. She enjoys playing outdoor and I don't. I would play with dolls, and she'll play with marbles, pellet guns, text, or anything that boy would enjoy playing. But even though she has that aura, I remember when she was in year 3 or 4, when someone tried to bully her, she came to me and told me someone is trying to bully her. I was like, can I actually face who's trying to bully her? And why can't she protect herself? She's more manly than me. But I have no choice but to pretend that I can face those bullies. I also have another story of commemoration of the relationship. I remember that time she called me early morning and got worried because it was too early in the morning. She said, Ate, I have something to tell you, with her kinikilig voice. She whispered, Kami na ni Klyde. I was like, really? Are you na ni Klyde? As soon as I said it, Joseph jumps out of bed and screaming. He was like, what? Did you just said Kris and Klyde are dating now? That day, me and Joseph was so happy and can't stop ourselves from teasing Kris. Kris, Now that you have the man of your dreams, all I can say is to stay happy and stay in love. You two are truly meant for each other. With all that long wait and obstacle that you face in 7 years of your relationship, I'm telling you, there's more to come. More challenges, challenges that will make your relationship stronger. As long as you have God in your relationship, no obstacles, no trials can break you apart. You both grew as a mature adult with lots of wisdom about how to build a strong, positive family. Once again, congratulations and best wishes on both of you. To end my speech, I would like to propose to the beautiful couple, please raise all your glasses and cheers to a happily married life. Thank you.
Round of applause for the bride sister all the way from Canberra, Ate KC. Thank you, Ate.
And I thank you. All right, our next part of the program will be the dances of the couple and with the parents as well.
How long will I love you? Long as stars are above you, and longer if I can. How long will I need you? As long as the seasons need to follow their plan. How long will I be with you? As long as the sea is bound to wash upon the sand. Will I want you? As long as you want me to, and longer by far. How long will I hold you? As long as your father told you, as long as you can. Longer if I may.
Thank you so much, Tita Maureen and Clyde. Next up, may we call on our bride, Kris, to have a dance with her father, Tito Christopher.
Come stop your crying, it will be all right. Just take my hand, hold it tight. I will be
congratulations. And that was the dance with the bride and her father. And for the second, for the next dance, we are going to witness the bride and the groom, the bride and the groom dance with Reva serenading them.
Thank you. boy, baby, do a leap and make him dance when it come.
Thank you so much, Klyde and Kris. Another round of applause for our couple. If you wanna run away with me, I know a galaxy and I can take you for a ride. I have been friends with these two for the last 10 years, and I must say, they are two of the best dancers I know.
All right, so for this one, Kris or Klyde, are you ready?
Kris or Klyde, are you ready? Right, first question. Who said I love you first?
Guys.
Po, kailangan niyo pong pumila po sa harapan.
Galaw.
Kris or Klyde, go! Oh yeah! Five, four, three, two, one.
All right.
Okay. Who do you think said I love you first? The correct answer
is Kris
and Klyde. Wait. All right.
Wait lang. Music down, please, for a bit.
All right. Audience, black.
Okay. Audience, the. Ayan, wala na. All right, the prize for this game is a taste of something. But audience, please, the answer to that is when we ask them the question. When I asked Kris the question, she said it was. Kris. When I asked Klyde the question, he did say Klyde. So for that, or either it's the other way, but then they both said Kris or Klyde. So the answer to that is Kris and Klyde. So pareho po panalo.
But that's just a trial, guys. So the next questions will just be one answer. It will either be a Kris or a Klyde.
Yes, and para po sa pagod ninyo, the prize for this game is a taste of Kris's favorite red wine. All right? Woohoo! Did you know that Kris drinks wine too? Yes, she does. She just started recently though. Nah. All right. So, second question. The person who gifted a love capsule to the partner.
Kris or Klyde? Five,
four,
three,
two, one. Tama na po, Tigel. All right.
No switching. Okay. So what's our correct answer? The correct answer is...
Kris.
Kris. Okay. All right. Guys, thank you so much. You may have a seat now. Wait. Sorry, tapos na pong trial natin. Next question.
Ayan. Half na, 50% na lang.
Next question
is, the person who reckons marriage is fun. So we've asked them three words about marriage, and one said gift, one said commitment, the other said fun. Who said marriage is fun? All right. Now, who said marriage is fun? Is it Kris or Klyde? All right.
Okay.
Okay.
Biglang dumami yung players.
Biglang dumami ang players. But Klyde, I feel the love, Klyde, of your fans. But the answer is...
Kris!
So the question is...
The question is, who initiated the first kiss? Is it Kris or Klyde? Five, four, three, two, one. Okay.
And
the correct answer, who initiated the first kiss?
The answer is...
Klyde! Team Kris, salamat po. Pwede na po kayong umupo. The winners, please stay here.
All right, next question is...
Who chose the first honeymoon location? Wait!
All right, that's Sige good, na. That's good!
Okay. All right! I think nakapila ni sila, Regine.
Okay, so who chose the first honeymoon location?
The correct answer is Klyde! Sorry, Team Kris. Upo muna kayo. All right, we are down to our final four players. Next question. All right, the next question. Jokingly,
this person's fear is the partner. Why would you fear someone you love? Just kidding. Maybe it's not that. Maybe it's something else. But is it Kris or Klyde? All right.
It's 3-1. It's Whoa. 3-1. All right. What's the correct answer, Regine?
The correct answer is Klyde.
Klyde.
Okay. So for that one, the greatest fear for Klyde, while Kris would say ghost, Kris would say ghost, Klyde said fear of losing the partner, which is so sweet. I love it. Anyway, next question. Who takes the longest shower between the two?
Kris or Klyde?
All right.
What's the correct answer, Regine?
The correct answer is Klyde.
Sorry, Bea.
Now we know.
Now we are down to our final two.
Oh, ayan. Ito, paunahan na po to, ha? Okay, paunahan na to. And this is the question about nagtanggal na ng heels. I love it. All right. The last question will be...
Who felt the love first?
All right. Wait lang.
Teka lang.
Teka lang po. Kasi I thought this was a question with a definite answer, but I need to ask... All right, so apparently the first person to felt the love or who fell in love will be, and this is a shocking fact after everything that I've heard, The first person is Klyde! Klyde, sa lahat ng nagsabi na crush ni Kris, si Klyde po ang unang nagmahal. Alright, thank you so much. And the winner is...
Herson! Naku, makakapag-uwi siya ng wine tonight!
So, Kris and Klyde, sa lahat ng mga nakakakilala sa inyo, it is Herson. Herson who wins the star. Alright, okay. So, the next part of the program will be our speeches from our gorgeous ninangs and ninongs. And we will start with, so this one is a couple speech. So we'll ask the couple to please come in front and say what you want to say to the couple. So we'll have Mr. Rafael and Mrs. Dominica Quinto as the first.
Congratulations, Kris and Klyde. We are honored to be chosen as your ninang and ninong. And this is just a short message. Marriage is not easy. It's a lot of hard work. It's proven. But that hard work should be a labor of love and patience. It is a work that you should both enjoy doing it. Okay? And always remember that communication is key to a successful marriage. Communicate verbally, emotionally, and physically. Nobody is a mind reader. Remember the promises you made today and let God be the center of your marriage. Again, congratulations to both of you.
It's your turn.
Congratulations.
Kinakabahan.
Kinakabahan ako ba sa mga ganitong... portion na. Pero ginugol ko para may ihanda rin naman ako. Sabi sa Google, being married is a big responsibility. And with these responsibilities, we create stress, quarrels between husband and wife. We cannot escape the scenario where the husband and wife gets into a fight. They may sound funny sometimes because they tend to say things that they did not sake of love. It is often an husband and wife also quarrel about the salary, who is going to pay the next bill. Ito na yung joke na sinabi dito. Nahuli ng Mrs. si Mr. na nag-beer house. Sabi ni Mr. agad, nag-beer house ako, ang 1,000 ang nagastos ko. Kaya nga, 1,000, nasa na 1,000? Yung 200, binayad ko sa beer. Tapos yung 800, binigay ko sa dancer. Kasi walang damit. Awang-awa ako. Yun lang, congratulations.
Wow, that was really funny. Thank you so much, Mr. Rafael and Mrs. Dominica Quinto. Thank you po. For our next pair, may we welcome Mr. Depot and Mrs. Celeste Valdez.
We are one, siya lang.
Ure, basit lang. I'm not very good in talking to a crowd. Congratulations na lang. It's beginning pa lang. It's beginning. Jay kunan ni pastor nga just put God in between. Depi man suti the best nga kunan na pimantap no. I mean nga everything that numan na dati tests or trials, still God will do the end. Of course, loving each other. Dahil lang. Congratulations.
As your second parent, mm-hmm. We're always here for you guys, okay? Yes. Congratulations.
And so.
Wow. Thank you so much, Mr. Depot and Mrs. Celeste Valdez. And next, later on, we will have Mr. Anderson and Mrs. Jane Olsen.
I would like to start this talk with a giving of a joke. I'd like to warn the ladies na yung mga mag-aasawa pa. I think Kris is a very good example here. Don't be fooled by a gentleman. Meron daw isang dalaga, sabi ng binata, kung mapapangasawa mo ako, hindi ka maghuhugas ng pinggan. Hindi ka magluluto. Hindi ka maglilinis, hindi ka maglalaba. Wow! Diba, ang sarap pakinggan pag dalaga ka. So this young lady, tinanggap ka agad. He said, wow! Nagmayabang pa sa magulang. Sabi niya, meron ako mapapangasawa, hindi raw ako maghuhugas, hindi ako magluluto, hindi ako maglilinis, hindi ako maglalaba. And the parents of the lady was very... They were amused, and they said, well, ang gawin natin, ato na, tayo na lang gagastos. Nakakaya naman sa mapapangasawa mo. And, yeah, it happened. After the marriage, you know what? It was true. The lady doesn't cook. The lady doesn't wash the dishes. The lady doesn't wash the clothes. And the lady, because the lady doesn't clean the house. She doesn't cook because nothing to cook. She doesn't wash the clothes because there's nothing to wash. She doesn't clean the house because there's no house to wash. So don't be fooled. Ang masasabi ko lang sa wedding na ito, I'm going to remember this wedding for a long, long time. This wedding is very, very memorable to me. They said that I'm going to give a wisdom to say something to this beautiful couple. But I'm humbled today, actually, because this wedding, I learned a lot. I've seen things that's so different. Maraming nagsasabi na pag nalalasing sila, they will not understand the things that they said and they heard. Medyo nakatatlong baso na rin ako, pero I've learned the art of remembering everything people say to me. Even if I'm drunk, I remember everything I heard in this wedding. What the parents said, what the friends said, and most especially, I remember your vows. A lot of things in your vows that I never said to my wife, and I apologize for that, Jane. But thanks be to the Lord, because more than 20, we are still married. So, well, marriage is, every marriage, I believe. Thank you for those who talked earlier, because everything you have said is true. But I can say that every marriage is a unique marriage. It's a unique marriage. And I'm glad that you both believe in the Lord. And as you grow older, as you live together as husband and wife, as you live together as to become parents, that you will have those unique experiences that not only you will learn, but to us also. And lastly, I'm thinking, my wife and I are very young to be a ninong and ninang. But I'm humbled that you chose us to be among them. And we cannot promise you anything. But when the going gets rough, we live in Swanview. You come there, knock on our doors, and we will be there. We cannot promise you money. We cannot promise you materials. But rest assured that we can sacrifice things for the betterness of your marriage. We are not very much experienced people to give you wisdom, but we will try our best to help you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your speech, Mr. Anderson and Mrs. Jane Olsen. And now we're going to listen to Mr. Nick and Mrs. Beverly Cablog. Oh, for that one, we are moving on to Mr. Justado and Mrs. Rose Acabo.
I would like to wholeheartedly congratulate Kris and Klyde for a blissful wedding, as well as to wish you both a happy married life. This wedding is not the end, but the beginning of life together, filled with love, happy memories, as well as challenges, trials, and heartbreak that you will both face along the way. But what can I say? That's part of married life too. One of the most important things to keep in mind when overcoming problems is communication. Don't go to bed angry and always face any problems together. Do not assume that the person will know what's on the person's head. In short, bawal ang assuming at hulaan. Always support each other, either through ups and especially downs, and value the friendship and love that both of you have shared and flourished throughout the years. Thank you very much for choosing us as one your sponsor. I know Kris for a long, long time. I know she's very good. Yeah, thank you very much for choosing us. The whole family is welcoming you as our friend and Klyde. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much for that. Mr. Justado and Mrs. Reyes Acabo, and part of the marriage will be soon. May mga anak din pong maninigaw sa gilid. Just kidding. All right. Just a quick check. Can you still hear us from the back? Yeah? All right. Thank you for that. All right. So those are the speeches for our ninang and ninongs. And we are moving on to the next batch of speeches.
All right, next part of the speeches, we'll be calling on the siblings and some friends. May we first call on to the front, Ariel.
What's up, madlang people? Hindi pala to showtime. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna try and compose myself because, as many of you know, I'm a crybaby. But I'm gonna go through this. Firstly, I just want to wish you both congratulations. You finally made it today after 7 years, so happy anniversary. Wait lang. The first time I met Kris, I just turned 16, and I just started dating her little brother, Pod. Mama! My first impression of Kris, tumboy ba si ate mo? She was so boyish. She did karate. She had the black belt. She was too cool. You know, she was too cool for anything. She didn't care about anything. If YOLO was a person, it was Kris. And we can all agree. And then I heard about Kuya Klyde. I've always known Kuya Klyde as one of my closest friends, Riva's big brother. So I've always known him as a kuya. Masungit siya. Kasi guidance siya eh. He's a protector. He's a kuya. And then when they started dating, I'm not gonna repeat what everybody repeated, but when they started dating, and when I met them both together as a couple, I've come to realize that my perceptions of them from the very first time was different. Their smiles are brighter, their eyes are more colorful, and their hearts are definitely fuller. And I truly believe that it's because true love is making each other better people. True love is bringing out the best of each other. And that's what you, Kris and Klyde, have done for each other throughout the past 7 years.
Thanks, guys. Ate and Kuya, my wish for you is a happy and fun marriage. I hope that it's always full of adventure. It's always full of petty quarrels. It's always full of light, laughter, faith, and of course, love. I can't wait to meet the loud little nephews and nieces that Kuya Klyde talked about in his vows, to dress them up and teach them how to take a selfie. I know hindi magiging perfect kahit anong relationship, but continue to do what you've been doing for the past 7 years. Continue to forgive, continue to understand, to respect, and continue to be each other's best friends. Tulad nga ng lolo at lola ko at ng mama at papa ko, kahit na laging nagbabangayan about sa maliliit na bagay, at the end of the day, they know they can't live without each other, because without each other, they're incomplete. Happy anniversary, guys, and congratulations.
Thank you so much, Ariel, for that heartfelt message. May we now call on John to share their message to the couple.
Grabe yung cheer. Hindi ako sasayaw. Hi, Kris and Klyde. I was just talking to Kris earlier today, and I just can't believe that we're finally here. Like, who would have thought many years ago we were just, you know, cooking burgers, making burgers, cutting chickens at Red Rooster, and that's how I got to know you, and I'm very glad that, you know, after all these years, we've kept the friendship. Like, you guys are... You're really great people, and I know I speak for everyone who knows you, and I admire you very much, Kris and Klyde. Klyde, like, you're such a good guy, and I couldn't imagine anyone else better for Kris. Like, you deserve each other, and I know that you're gonna take care of her, and I'm breathing. Sorry, it's a bit of a walk. And Kris, I've already said this at your hen's party, but you're the life of the party. Your joy is just so infectious. It's so contagious. And I just love having you around, that even though we don't see each other as much, like, the friendship is there. And I know I could always count on you, having our deep, meaningful talks about life, about religion, about spirituality, about everything else. And now here we are, after years of adulting, we're finally here. You're here at your next stage, next step in your journey, and we can't wait to see what's next, what's ahead of you. I'm really glad just to celebrate this moment with you. The joy and the love that we can definitely see. And just really, really, really happy for you. That's all.
Thank you so much for that message, John. We would like to call on now the brother of the bride, Welford. Please come to the front.
Hello, good evening, everyone, and congratulations to you, Ate Kris, Kuya Klyde. Welcome to the family, Kuya Klyde. I just want to say na I lost a brother, bagay na brother. If you guys know what I mean, you know? Nawala lang ako ng kainuman, pero may bago akong kainuman. So, win-win, win-lose, pero... Ang ano ko lang, wish ko lang sa inyo is like, let's stay drunk together, but ano lang, like, be patient to each other and communicate and love each other. And ang masasabi ko kay Kuya Klyde, like, he's been a really good, ano, like, brother to me. to our family. He's been really good to us. Hindi ko alam kung ba't na gusto niya si Ate Kris. I don't know, like... Yeah, but thank you. And kay Ate Kris, ang message ko sa kanya, sana huwag na siya maging maarte, magpakalalaki ka ulit. Dati kung may ipis, aapakan niya. Ngayon, Klyde, may ipis. What happened, bro? Dati sinisipang mga lalaki, ngayon, oh my God. But, well, but yeah. Ngayon na tumanda na kayo, kailangan ko na bagong kainuman. So, I'm waiting for another nephew. But, that's it. Thank you everyone and good night. Congratulations there.
Thank you so much, Welford. It's now time to hear from the Klyde's family. May I call on the sister of the groom, Reva?
Okay, so I did not prepare a speech at all. I hate how you like to put me in an uncomfortable spot, like seriously. Oh my God, I hate you guys. Anyway, I have nothing much to say. I mean, everything's been said. And I said everything on your hands party. I don't want to cry again. I guess I just want to say congratulations to both of you. Finally, you're married. I was just telling Manong Roxy that I can't believe it. Like, yeah, you're here. And then all the stress and all that, it's all gone. You're going to go to Margaret River or something like that. And just relax. I guess, what do I want to say? Mom and Dad and even Manong Kyle saying that we've lost a brother or something like that. I also said that in your hands party, but I just realized, not really. We've just gained another sister. I've gained another sister and I'm so happy for that. Can you still understand me? You look like you don't understand what I'm saying. Anyway, I guess I'm gonna say the same thing I said at Manong Kyle's wedding. If someday na mag-aaway kayo or parang yung magtatapunan na kayo ng plato tulad ng sabi ni Tito, na balikan niyo yung vows ninyo kasi that's your promise to each other and you made that promise under his name. Sana hindi niyo lang baliwalain kasi, you know, isipin niyo yung feelings niyo nung sinusulat niyo yun. And sana pag yun nga pag nag-away kayo, parang babalik lang ulit. And then you actually do the things that you promised you would do for each other, like you would climb mountains with her and the other stuff that you said, Manong Kris. I don't know what else to say. I don't want to cry, like I said. I'm probably going to say things to you in private because I'm that kind of person. I love you both. Congratulations.
Thank you, Reva, for that wonderful message. And last but not the least, may I call on Elvis?
Yeah, earlier somebody came up to me and just told me like, oh, you know, somebody was talking already. Oh, obviously, I was the last one I just mentioned. But obviously, with all the people that have spoken before me, everybody have told them pretty much everything. And at the same time, you know, those really the general advice of being a married couple. Obviously, I'm not gonna touch on that because I'm not on that stage yet. But obviously, it's a long conversation. I mean, it's a long advice that you guys have already. Received and somebody came up to me and said, hey, it kind of resonates to you, like, you know, yeah, you just better cut off your time a little bit. So here I am, I'm trying to like kind of summarize everything, and all I can see is that just, I think all I can say is that you guys, we've witnessed you from obviously with the group, the entire group, in behalf of the whole group that have seen you growing from the very beginning. Obviously we've had Kris that came into the group first, and you know, we've known already that Kris has longing for this guy, and we weren't quite sure who this guy was at the very beginning, but you know, she's had her thoughts on this, you know, the ideal man, and then Klyde came in afterwards, and we were like sort of like, oh, we didn't know, and she's like getting frustrated, like she said that the ceremony early at the vows, and yeah, it's good to see that finally we're here at this stage, and you know, we've spent nights and even up to the morning, and the sun was already coming up, and endless, you know, conversations, and I'm glad to be part of that, and obviously with all of us witnessing this next stage of being a married couple, I guess there's just one thing that kind of to me that I would say that maybe not touched on by all of the people earlier is just having the tolerance and understanding, and we understand that if we had troubles understanding one person, and everybody has their own identity, right? And now being a married couple, every couple would have their own identity too. So I know and I'm confident that with the identity of you being a married couple, there would be like, you guys would be amazing. And I hope to see that part of both of you, like, you know, being together, whatever this lies in the future, will be, you know, amazing to see what lies ahead. But yeah, thank you guys for being part, and I'm happy to witness all of that in behalf of Monday Group. And thank you all for listening.
Thank you so much, Elvis. Okay, I think we're ready to move on to the next part of the program. Okay pa ba kayo dyan?
So, for the next part of the program, we will have
all the single ladies. Are you ready? The tossing of the bouquet is the bride's way of sharing her happiness and may find that person who might walk the aisle next. Okay, ready na po ba tayo? All right, in 3, 2, 1! Ah! 3, 2, 1! All right, Ate Dani!
Where is the garter coming from? We shall witness it. Are you ready, Klyde? All right. Yes. I don't,
Shall we add a bit of twist to this, Regine?
The twist will be, Klyde, it will be remove the garter from Kris
without using your hands.
Hindi ako yon.
Joke lang.
But traditionally, binding the groom and the bride together is the garter. And the tossing means for all the bachelors out there, it's your time to find that extra lock as well. And to meet that sweet person to make your journey complete. All right, okay. Go!
Go, Klyde!
All right, woohoo! All right, guys, are you ready? Okay, One, two, three, go! Whoa!
Jello, are you ready?
Okay lang ba? Okay lang, relax. Kamay naman eh. Okay.
All right, instruction, you just have to put the garter up to the knee height of Ate Dani. Okay?
But this one, pag bibigyan ka naman, you can use your hands.
Balak!
We're going to have the short, sweet dance between Dani and Jello.
Now they will be joined by Kris and Klyde on the dance floor. Thank you so much.
All right, I think we're ready.
All right, is everyone ready? Okay, everyone who's playing, please come closer. We need to see who, all the players, okay. You will look for an opponent and you will only have one attempt to win.
And one.
One attempt to win, and whoever loses will surrender their $5 to the winner. And that winner will look for another opponent and play the Jack and Poi again. Until we have one man standing.
Okay, all right.
Ready? On my count.
Okay, wait lang. Trial, no? Trial, one, two, three.
Trial po to, trial. Okay. Ready?
Jack and Poi! Ah!
Okay, okay. Trial lang po, trial lang po.
Okay, okay. Ready?
This is the real game. Totohanan na po
to. Totohanan na to. Kami
okay.
Muna.
Okay. Ready.
All right. One. Kami mo, kami po muna.
All okay. Right. Ready on air count.
One.
Ready. Jack and Boy. All right. The win. Okay. Lahat na po may $10. Okay. Okay, okay. All right, losers, please take your seat or stand on the side. All the winners, come closer to me, please. Round two, jump and boy. Okay. Nako, yumayaman po tayo dito. Okay, all the winners, please stand here. Okay. All the winners, please stand here. Okay, everyone has a partner? Everyone ready? All right, on my count, ready? Jack and boy! Okay. Surrender, loser, surrender your money. Okay. How many are left? Okay. Oh. Okay. All right, all the winners, can we all go to the front? Oh, okay, another round. Players, ready? Jump and boy. Okay. Oh my God. Oh, yung mga manok niyo. Okay.
All
next
right.
Next round, we're ready. Okay, sino player? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, Japong and Eric. Okay, John and Eric.
All right.
Everyone ready? All right. On my count.
Okay.
Jump and point.
How much is it?
Draw, okay, one more. Okay, ready. Jump and boy.
Ah! I'm late.
Okay, interview. Okay. May I just ask you, ano po ang gagawin niyo sa pera?
Ay, tatabi pa na.
Pangbibingo daw po.
Po, pag kayong mananalo, what will you do?
I'll put all of those money to my charity work. Charot.
Charity work, aka myself. All right, wow. Aba, all right, can
pero
you
pang
can just
Erich, may bubulong sa akin. What is the essence of being?
You
only have one chance. Either you lose the 100 or you gain another 100.
Woohoo!
Okay, ready, Nita? Ready, Eric? Okay, ready, on my count.
Wait lang.
Ganun ba?
Oh, ganun kayo dapat. Jack and boy, ganun. Labas sa boy.
Practice. Jack and boy, okay.
Practice po yun.
Okay. Alright!
Alright!
Ito na po talaga. This is the real game na. Okay, Tita ready? Erich ready? Alright, here we go. For $230,
Jack and Poy!
Jack and Poy!
Jack and Poy!
Jack and Poy! Tita, $230! Tita Karina from the Adon family. So we will put this blind blindfold on you. We'll be asking a few people from the audience, some gentlemen from the audience, and you will be guessing and try to pull out where Klyde will be by feeling his hands, ears, and
the cheeks and the nose. However, the twist for this one will be the first part is you're only allowed to touch the hands first. If you can actually find Klyde already by the first round, it means you really, really know Klyde.
So Kris is just going to feel their right hand, okay? Where's Klyde? Oh, there, okay. All right, let's just make sure the groom is with us. Okay, so guys, rearrange yourself. Klyde, magtago ka muna somewhere. All right, this is the first round of Is This Your Husband? All right, number two is, no. All right, so it's a no for number three. Next one. If you're unsure, Kris, you can also put them on the side first. Kinilig ako doon. Oh my God, 7 years pa naman.
Kinabahan si Klyde.
Well done, Kris.
Oh my God, Kris, well done. Klyde.
I think it's Clyde's turn.
Nako, it's a request of Kris as well. Kinabahan talaga si Klyde doon.
So what was your basis, Kris? Paano mo siya nahanap agad?
I knew it already because he have a hairy hands.
Oh!
And a small nail finger.
Hindi ako kumuha ng hairy hands kanina, sayang.
All right, wow. Ako kinabahan din talaga ako doon, ha? Parang sabi ka, we should have not played this game kanina.
Well
but done. We did. So now it's the turn for Klyde.
All right. Blindfold for Klyde, please.
All
Where's
right.
our blindfold?
Blindfold, please. All right,
Klyde. And remember, okay, you can if you're unsure, you can say yes or no, and we'll put them on the side, and we'll do some elimination, okay? Alrighty. Our candidate number one.
No daw po.
No, okay. Candidate number one. Uh-huh. Candidate number two. Is it a yes, a maybe, or a no? A no?
No.
Okay.
No daw po.
Binibini number three.
Ladies, huwag kayong masaktan.
No?
No.
Okay.
Sure, Shana, no.
Thank you.
Oh, sige.
Number four.
Next one.
Is it a yes? No? Maybe?
Ganyan ba kaliit ang arms ni Kris?
Pwede.
Pwede ba?
Pwede ata. Is it a maybe? a yes or a no?
No. No. All right.
Okay.
No.
Now we're down to our final five.
Final five. Ganyan ba kaliit din ang kamay ni Kris?
Maybe.
You think so?
Maybe or yes. Maybe. Okay, we'll get you to stand on the side, please. We have three more to go.
All right.
Three more to go. Next, please.
All right.
Okay. Is it a yes, a no, or a maybe? No, sorry. Next one. No? Okay. We're down to our last two. No? Okay, and our final one. Huh? Sure? Okay, take out your blindfold. Hala! Oh! Oh my God!
Wow! Ramdam ko yung kaba!
Wow! How did you feel, Clyde?
How did you feel?
She was the second one, right?
No, the first one that you said maybe, and her is the same person. So well done. Well done, Kris. Well done, Clyde.
You oh my see. God. Wow. A big round of applause for the couple po.
Okay, I think it's now time to hear from the couple for their messages for tonight. Let's start off with Clyde.
We'll just use this mic. Because this is the special mic.
Okay. First of all, thank you so much for everyone who came tonight. Since the ceremony up to now, you know, I know everyone's very tired and very sleepy as well, I think. And thank you for taking your time off because today is a Monday. We really, really appreciate that. I hope you guys enjoyed the food that we prepared for everyone, the drinks, everything. We have takeaway tokens for everyone over there. It's crinkles made by Tim's mom, so please grab one before you leave. and also grab some food and take some desserts over here because we don't want them to go to waste. I really can't pinpoint each and every one of you who's been really helpful and who's been actually who made this one this our married wedding possible. But from the bottom of our hearts, we really really appreciate your help. And we appreciate your presence here with us tonight as well. We invite you for our traditional wedding celebration at Kris's place in Camilo, at 46 Excalibur Circle, Camilo. It will be a traditional celebration of our wedding. It'll be from 3 p.m. onwards to Sawa. So, anything you want to add?
Thank you so much for coming, guys. We really appreciate your time and effort. And this wedding won't be as great as like this if you guys not here participating with every games and pretty much joining us. And the reason we invited each one of you guys here is because you've been part of our relationship. Me and Clyde were talking about having an intimate wedding. However, we thought like, you know what? These people that here right now are the people who knows our relationship. And that means a lot to us that you are here. And I hope that that you enjoyed and you grabbed some sort of wisdom and happiness, joy. That's what makes, you know, the wedding is. And I'm really, really grateful for your time. And same thing with my family, Clyde's family. This event won't be like this, or it won't be a perfect like this. And I'm very grateful from the bottom of my heart, I can't really say any words, but thank you so much. And we love you guys so much. Thank you so much. And daming thank you so much, no?
Thank you, Dean.
And now, we officially open the dance floor. We still have some time. Let's get those calories.
Yes, thank you.
Burn, let's do this.